I received a phone call from Billy's friend Gus, who was currently on the mountain with Billy, who had just crashed his bike and landed on a rock. The Westpac helicopter was there, just about to winch him out. Billy was fine, except he couldn't move his legs. We knew he had a significant spinal injury and that he was being flown to Christchurch for emergency surgery and to have the best possible recovery. So what did that all mean? We had no idea. I had a pretty good understanding of spinal injury, but I had no idea of the extent of Billy's injury until we were sitting in that room with the spinal team and going through the x-rays. It was pretty horrific. I couldn't believe you could injure yourself like that just biking with your mates on a Saturday morning. But you can. That's the way my spinal injuries occur. Just random acts. Absolutely sick. I couldn't believe that Billy had this injury. Till this day, I still can't believe he has this injury. But he does. And how do I feel? I feel devastated that he has to go through so much growing up so quickly. But he is an incredible kid with an incredible outlook, and his constant positivity has made and enabled me to accept his injury that much better. Stop. We got here today through support through a load of people we know very well, people we don't know at all, and people we've met along the way. There have been some incredible people that we have met, and we are so privileged to be a part of an incredible system to support people with spinal cord impairment. Without the support of the New Zealand Spinal Trust today and their team, their support with people like Mike Brown, Billy has not been able to get to where he is today as a well-adjusted, active 16-year-old. So please donate to the New Zealand Spinal Trust and help support people like Billy and families to make the most out of their injury and to be able to move forward with a community behind them. Thank you.